Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Wabihi nasta'inu ala umurid dunya wad-din. Wassalatu wassalamu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in amma ba'd. First of all, we praise and thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the blessings that we have, including the blessings that we have today. So today is Friday, which is the best day of the week in Islam. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, whoever comes to the Friday prayer and listen to the khutbah attentively, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive his sins until the next Friday. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the one whom he forgive. Amin, amin ya Rabbil Alamin. So for today inshallah, I would like to remind myself and all of us here about the ibadah in Islam. And I believe all of us know that the main reasons of the creations of mankind in this world is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the main reasons. That's the main obligations, which is worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in surah Adz-Dzariyat, this is surah or chapter 51, ayat 56. This is a well-known ayat. A'udzu billahi minasy syaithanir rajim. Wa ma khalaqtul jinna wal insa illa liya'budun. Wa ma khalaqtul jinna wal insa illa liya'budun. And I did not create the jinn and mankind except to worship, to serve me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the main reason of the creation of all of us over here, which is to serve, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In other words, to perform what we call the ibadah. Because worship, serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have to be done with action. And this action in Islam is called the ibadah. So what is ibadah? Based on the etymology, ibadah or worship means humbleness, lowliness, and submissiveness. In the terminology, ibadah means obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by carrying out what he has commanded as shown by his messengers. So there are two things over here that related to the ibadah. And these two things, or these two requirements, are needed to make sure that our ibadah will be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What are these two requirements? What are these two requirements? The first one is called ikhlas or sincere. It has to be performed to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only. And this is the most important requirement for our action, for our ibadah. All action has to be sincerely done to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not for other things. What is the second requirement for the ibadah to be accepted? Ittiba. Ittiba means follows the examples or the guidance given by our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because there are some ibadah that we cannot perform without guidance, without examples from our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So these are the two requirements for our action, our ibadah to be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which is the first one is sincerity. The second one is ittiba, following the example given by our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. However, before we go to this requirement one by one, I would like to inform you that there are actually two kinds, two principles of ibadah. The first one is called the ritual. Ibadah madhoh, which is the ritual ibadah. The action that has to be performed follow the rules. There is the arkan, there is a rukun for this ritual. The second ibadah is called the ghairu mahdoh, which is the ibadah or the action that is not really, there is a rules on it, but this action has to be good. There is no arkan, there is no rukun for this second ibadah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in surah Az-Zariyat that all the purpose of man creation is to perform ibadah. So everything that we do is actually ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Action to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But however, again, there are two types of ibadah. The first one is the ibadah that has ritual in it. There is a rukun, there is a rules in it. And we have to follow this ibadah based on the guidance, the examples given by our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If we do not follow this, then it is considered as the what we call the bid'ah dolalah. Because the rukun, we have to follow it. Otherwise, we are actually not follow the example of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Like for example, salah, fasting, hajj, umrah, that all they have arkan. Wudu, there is an arkan, there is a rukun. This is a ritual that we have to follow. Otherwise, it is considered as bid'ah if we make a new rule for our own self. The second type of ibadah is ghairu mahdoh, which is, it is not ritual, there is no arkan, there is no rukun, but it is still ibadah to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The easy example is what we do right now. In our masjid, we have carpet, we build a mosque, we build a hospital, that's all is ibadah too. But there is no rukun, for example, you know, there is an arkan for building the mosque, etc. And then we have to follow the arkan. No, there is nothing like that. So this second action, as long as it is not against the principle of Islam, the principle of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is should be beneficial individually, socially, it is okay to perform that action. Even though it is a new invention. This is what we call the sunnatun hasanah, the good example. So we go back to the requirements for all of this ibadah to be accepted, which is two. The first one is sincerity. It has to be ikhlas. It has to be sincere to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He mentioned this in the Quran. وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا mukhlisina lahuddina hunafa aw yuqimu shalah wa yutuz zakata wa dzalika dinul qayyimah. This is the obligations. Allah Subhanahu wa taala said, I do not order you to perform thing except with the ikhlas, mukhlisin in your religions. Do salah, give zakah, and this is the correct religion. So ikhlas over here is the first requirement of ibadah to be accepted. And maybe some people ask, how about people that do not believe in God, do not believe in Allah, but they perform a lot of good things? They build hospitals, they build schools. How about this kind of people? First, this is in Islam. This is actually not really our, you know, job to really bother them. You know, it's like going to them and saying, hey man, your action will not be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because you do not believe in Allah. No, this is not the way of Islam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran that this kind of action is not accepted, it's not for them, it is for us. It is for us. This is reminder for us that whenever we perform ibadah, we have to perform it to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, this is in surah Al-Kahfi. A'udzu billahi minasy syaithanir rajim. Qul hal nunabbi'ukum bil akhsarina a'mala alladziina dhalla sa'yuhum fil hayatid dunya wa hum yahsabuna yuhsinuna sunna ulaika alladziina kafaru bi ayati rabbihim wa liqa'ihi fahabitat a'maluhum fala nuqimu lahum yaumal qiyamati wazna. This is really clear. This is for us. Again, this is for us. Reminder for us. Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, Kul hal nunabbi'ukum, should I tell you about people that believe they have performed, done a very good action? They build the hospital, they build the library, they build roads. A lot of things, they do good action. But they are actually the great loser. Why? These people, those effort is lost in worldly life while they think that they are doing good job. They think they're doing a good job. Those are the one who disbelieve in the verses of their Lord and in their meeting with him, so their deeds have become worthless. And we will not assign to them on the day of resurrection any importance. So whatever they do in this dunya, their good action that they perform is nothing because they do not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they will not get anything in the hereafter. This is what we call the great loser. However, again, I mentioned before that it is not our job to really tell people what you're doing is wrong, right? Especially when they don't believe in God, that's their things. And this is for us. This is a reminder for us, if we do something, that make sure we do it to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because in another surah, in surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly mentioned, this is for the believers. This is for the believer that perform good action, but they also get nothing. So in the first surah, and the first verse that I mentioned, in surah Al-Kahfi 103 until 108, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions about the disbeliever, that their action will be worthless. However, in this surah, in this ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about us, the believer, the one that really believe in him, but we perform action that will be nothing. Why? A'udzubillahimna syaitanirrojim. Ya ayyuhalladzina amanu la tubtilu shadaqatikum bil manni wal adza kalladzi yunfiqu malahu ria'an nas wala yu'minu billahi wal yaumil akhir. Famathaluhu kamathali Safwan alaihi turab fa'asobahu wabilun fatarakahu solda. La yaqdiruna ala syai'im mimma kasabu. Wallahu la yahdil qawmal kafiri. It is really clear. This is one example that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned. Oh who you believe, this is for us. Oh who you believe, Do not invalidate your charities with reminders or injury as does one who spend his wealth only to be seen by people. They do not believe in Allah and the last day. So when we give something to someone as a charity, it has to be to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only. And we do not remind these people that we help. Like for example, if someone come to us, please help me. You know, I need to pay the blah, blah, blah. I need family to eat. And then you give it. Yes, you give it. Okay, this is $100. Remember, last month already give you $100. No, you ask me, okay? You are lazy. Okay? This is money wal adha. It's not only kind of, you know, reminding, okay, I give you already, and it's hurt his feeling. You are lazy, man. You are lazy. You have to work. You have to work. Maybe he already tried. But still, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala need us to help him. And we need, if we help, that make sure we do not say anything. We do not hurt his feeling or their feeling. Otherwise, whatever we do is worthless. Famasaluhu kamasali Safwan alaihi turab. The likeness of these people that give and then remind and hurt other when he give is like a smooth rock and there is a turab on it. There is a soils and dust on it. And then the rain come, and what happens with dust turab? It's gone. Okay, it's become bare stone, bare rock. La yaqdiruna ala syai'in mimma kasabu. There is nothing left for what he has done. He spent his money is gone, but he got nothing. So this is reminder for us, when we do something, do it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is better if you cannot help, then it is better to say, I'm sorry, brother, I cannot help you. Rather than saying something, you still give it, but saying something that hurt his feeling. That's worse than not giving. It doesn't mean that I kind of suggest you don't give. No, give if you have it. But if you don't have it, say I'm sorry. Rather than you give bit with a hurt, you know, feeling. That's the first requirement for our ibadah to be accepted. Ikhlas, sincerity. What is the second requirement? Ittiba. Follow the examples, the guidance for our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And again, for this, okay, I just remind you, there are two types of ibadah. The ibadah mahdho and ghairu mahdho. The mahdho is the ritual ibadah that have arkan, and we have to follow the example of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Otherwise, it's become what we call the bid'ah. The second one, the ghairu mahdho, the ibadah. Remember, all our action is actually ibadah, right? The ibadah that do not have arkan. There is no rule, there is no step by step like that. For this kind of ibadah, then it is okay to create a new kind of action, like building this mosque with carpet. It is a new invention, actually. Writing Quran is actually a new invention too. And it is not called as a bid'ah for this kind of type of ibadah. So there are two, okay, There are several hadith, actually I just want to give you two of them. This is the most famous one, usually, you know. For Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, fa inna asdaqal hadith kitabullah wa khairal hadith hadith Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam wa syarrul umuri muhdatsatuha wa kullu muhdatsatin bid'ah wa kullu bid'atin dalalah wa kullu dalalatin finnar. This is a very famous hadith, but many people actually don't really they make a generalization. It said that wa kullu bid'atin dalalah wa kullu dalalatin finnar. They said every invention is bid'ah and every bid'ah is dolalah and every dolalah is in the nar. So they say every. Okay. So I want to mention, they say this is only actually for the ritual, the one that has guidance, has examples provided by our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yes, if you make a new invention, like you know, you are very young, you know, the Fajr is only 2 raka'ah, you can perform it 8 raka'ah, why not? Doing 8 raka'ah. That's a bid'ah. You creating something that is not following the rule. But for the other things, the what is not ritual, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam clearly mentions, man sanna fil Islam sunnatun hasanah, falahu ajroha wa ajro man amila biha min ba'di min ghairi ayyan kusa min ujurihim syai'a. It is really clear, whoever in Islam creating something new, sunnatun hasanah, a good example, then he will give what? He will get the reward for his action, and the reward from man amila biha min ba'di, from people that perform his action, his good example, min ghairi ayyan kusa min ujurihim syai'a, without taking the reward of these people that perform that action. So it's actually a very, very, very good reward if we create something that is beneficial for other, helping other, and other follow us. That's a multiple reward. In the business, maybe called the MLM. Okay, so MLM is a multiple reward. And it is actually recommended action. Sunnatul hasanah. However, this is another thing. Waman sanna fil Islam sunnatul sayyi'ah. This is very harsh reminder. However, for someone, the believer, the Muslim, that creating something bad action, give the bad example to other people, kana alaihi wizruha, for him is the punishment. Okay. Wa wizru man amila biha min ba'dih, and also the punishment of people that follow him, follow his bad action continuously. You can imagine if that bad action is done by million of people. If we put that action in our Facebook, Facebook, and then everybody follow that, million of people, you know, follow that action. So you can imagine how many sayyi'ah, how many bad things that actually we get from this kind of action. This is a reminder that creating a good action, good example, is actually recommended. It's good for us, for others, and if it's multiplying reward. But on another hand, creating something bad, it is bad for us. Not only it is become punishment for us, the sayyi'ah, but also the people that perform that action, their punishment, their bad action also will be on us, because we the one that create that bad action. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding of this. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us easiness to perform good things, to follow the examples of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and also to be beneficial for many people, for the community. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilaik.